Good morning, friends. Yesterday, in our previous lecture, we have discussed about concept of educational technology. Today, we'll discuss about the role of educational practices. For seeing that, role of practices are the stimulation, guidance, direction, and encouragement for learning. It makes the learning process easy and effective. Effective educational practices at the classroom level are evidence-based methods that are not content-related and, when implemented with fidelity and informed through data, can produce positive, sustained results for every student. It must be for the benefit of the learners, and at the end they must be able to deliver the maximum they have learned during the class. It must be as effective that learners must recall the points discussed in their day-to-day life also whenever they come across such situation. To make educational practices visible requires an accomplished teacher as evaluator and activator who knows a range of learning strategies to build the students' surface knowledge, deep knowledge and understanding, and conceptual understanding. What are the types of educational practices? Till now, we have a lot of educational practices are there. Every teacher is practicing his own practice, but there is four or five educational practices are commonly used. What are they? First is assessment capable learners. It is based on students regulating and facilitating their own learning by accurately and appropriately answering the questions. What type of questions they are? Where am I going? Where am I now? How do I close the gap? So this is learner's assessment. He is learning himself. Where I have reached? As all of you are physical education students, you know your value. You have done BPED. Now you are doing MPED, and you are seeing it, that how you are covering the gap to achieve your goal. What is your ultimate goal? That is to achieve a job of teacher or director of physical education in some university. Then reciprocal teaching. Second, it is an effective educational practice and is defined as students summarizing, questioning, clarifying, and predicting. They take turns being the teacher. It has been introduced in 1984 by Palinkar and Brown. Next educational practice is based on feedback. It is called feedback practice. It is an effective teaching learning practice and is defined as an integral aspect of instruction and learning, utilizing information providing by an agent. What are that agents? They can be teacher, fee, book, parent, self-experience or computer. Regarding aspects of one's performance or understanding, the main purpose of feedback is to reduce discrepancies between current understanding or performance and some desired level of performance or goal. And now, fourth, which we have taken here, that is spaced versus massed practice. It is an effective teaching learning practice and is defined as spaced practice, being those conditions in which individuals are given rest intervals within the practice session, and massed practice being those conditions in which individuals practice a task continuously without rest. It has been introduced by Jay Donovan and D, Rhodes switch in 1999. Now we must see what are the basic functions there must be. What type of things must be there in a lesson which is supposed to be taught to the student. The content knowledge aligned with appropriate instruction must be there in the lesson. Then only a good practice can be done. Student engagement in subject matter. Subject must be created like this that students must be kept engaged in that. Then students' learning is taking place and it is also growing and developing. And then the next is students' goals. Whatever goal the student is having, the educational practice must achieve that. Then prior experiences, learning styles, multiple intelligences, strengths and needs, effective communication, sensitivity to culture, gender, intellectual and physical differences are also supposed to be there. Then technology and mass media communication tools must be utilized while preparing any type of lectures. Student assessment must be based on data analysis. Effective use of assessment must be done. Assessment data to improve learning. Whatever we have assessed and the data is collected, it must be seen toward teacher must analyze himself. If his students are getting only 60% marks, then he must think that he must provide some sort of change in his practice so that students can grab more and more and score more and more. Student-led assessment strategies must be there, in which students take leadership and assess themselves. Effect of instruction or individual learning must be there. Because if it is not there, then learning will be very dull and students will not be interested. Communication of student progress and maintaining records are supposed to be. These are some things which is supposed to be taken care of. Now we will talk about there is some norms for learners also. They must be respectful, they must be active listener, and also they must be open to new ideas. Because it is they who is supposed to learn them. Then use of notes for sidebar, conversations, be responsible. Be on time for sessions. Keep your cell phones on silent mode. Reply appropriately and be a problem solver, not a problem creator. Ask questions as needed to clarify concepts or directions. These are all for an effective role of educational technology in education processes. Thank you. All my details are given there, and if anyone is having any question, any query, he can contact me and ask me. Thank you very much once again.